I'm Clare Bond, and I'm a geologist, and I work in the School of Geosciences at the University of Aberdeen. Carbon capture and storage is when we take CO2 and we inject it into geological formations that are underground in the subsurface. We have some net zero targets that we're trying to meet, and carbon capture and storage can help us meet those net zero targets by taking the CO2 and putting it into the subsurface. So if we think that the UK CO2 output annually is about less than 500 megatons of CO2, so just in one geological storage formation, we could put enough CO2 in to abate the whole of the UK CO2 output in for a year. The ACON project is really leading carbon capture and storage in the UK, and from a Scottish point of view, there's such a carbon capture and storage resource offshore in the North Sea that really internationally we are leading the way in terms of working with other countries across the North Sea to really expand the possibilities for North Sea CO2 storage. As a geoscientist, what I'm interested in is in the rocks and the storage potential of the rocks in the subsurface. So really we're interested in the characteristics of the sediments, particularly their porosity and their permeability in terms of how much CO2 can be injected into the rock formation. So it's not a big cavern underground, it's more like a sponge is a really good kind of analogue for it. So you're injecting the CO2 into microscale pore spaces, and that CO2 needs to flow through those pores but actually then be captured in the rock. So we're interested in that storage reservoir and understanding how the CO2 might react with minerals and how it kind of stays within the rock once we've injected it. And then we're also interested in anything that might breach that storage. So it needs to have what we call a good cat rock or seal. So it needs a different type of rock that will help seal, that has much lower permeability, so very different properties. And then we also need it to withstand the pressure of putting in the CO2. So we need to understand the whole kind of rock system, and we can kind of model how that system will work as well as geoscientists. Carbon capture and storage is really important to meet our net zero targets. So if you look at the IPCC, so that's the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, they published this 1.5 degree kind of warming report, and they show in their modelling that carbon capture and storage has to happen to meet our targets. So it's really just one of several solutions, including alternative energy sources such as wind farms, geothermal energy, but carbon capture and storage is going to play a part in getting us to those net zero targets. The ACON project plans to store between 5 to 10 million tonnes of CO2 by 2030. Carbon capture and storage is really important in Scotland, and particularly in the northeast of Scotland, where we've had a really strong petroleum industry, and we can use all of that expertise that we've developed about the subsurface to really be at the forefront of changing in the energy transition to using that expertise for carbon capture and storage and geothermal and other uses of the subsurface to meet our net zero targets.